Zhang Lizong, the Chinese ambassador to Uganda, today paid a courtesy visit to the leader of opposition in parliament, Mathias Mpuuga, and held discussions on a number of issues of mutual relations. It's in this engagement that the issues of mistreatment of Ugandans in Chinese-owned companies and factories were put to the ambassador of China.
A few complaints from some of the workers, Ugandan workers, in the Chinese factories, about mistreatment. Okay, you need to encourage them to treat Ugandans. The Ugandans need these jobs. There's no doubt. We need these jobs, but they should be handled as people, treated well, respect their rights.
The law talked about harassment of staff and working long hours. So in our visitations, most people are saying they work for more than 14 hours a day, and that is really weird. Deep in the night, people are still at places of work.
The young women and girls who have had children with Chinese workers in Uganda, I will be particular, in the Karuma Hydropower Project, there are many young girls and women, Ugandan girls and women, who have had children with Chinese workers, and they have petitioned the embassy. I don't know how or if the matter has been handled.
Zhang Lizong attributed the problem to some Chinese who come in the country and set up factories without the knowledge of the embassy, which makes it hard for them to inspect their operations. He acknowledged that they have been getting cases of child neglect from several women, and they have been trying to connect them to their runaway fathers.
About some Chinese workers with local girls, women, marriage issues, I heard some of some reports. Sometimes we received some report, individual complaint or request, and we try to connect them with Chinese workers.
The opposition also raised queries of shoddy works on several infrastructure projects done by Chinese companies, plus unprecedented delays in completion of projects.
And there are many projects here falling under my docket. Specifically, I just want to comment about the roads. We have had so many complaints, and in our committee, we have visited some of the roads and projects being handled by Chinese companies. One, we really find some of the works wanting. They will find maybe there's no value for money.
We are told most of the companies are connected to the state, the Chinese companies here. So we would expect that they do genuine work. So we want to know, where is the problem? Is the problem with us that a road can take very many years?
The ambassador promised to do the needful by stepping up inspection of works, especially those done by companies owned by the Chinese government, to ensure they meet international standards.
I can assure you that we attach great importance to the quality of infrastructures. Once we get to know it, usually I instruct my commercial officials in the embassy to get in touch with relevant parties.
The leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, also brought it to the attention of the ambassador that Chinese companies have contributed to environmental degradation in the country by violating environmental conservation guidelines.
Extremely happy that you are able to attract many Chinese to come and invest in Uganda. But I want to encourage you to be interested in the environment. Because sustainability of these projects will depend a lot on how we protect the Ugandan environment.
For environmental situations, I think if we take Sinuk as an example, I think they are doing the best. They are following international standard, I think. They have very strict disciplines.
Zhang Lizong committed to doing better to improve in areas that have been lacking for the good of strengthening bilateral relations.
I feel the cooperation between China and Uganda is of mutual benefit. I think MPs doesn't
challenge me on this one. You know.
Story by Fred Kajibi for the news.